Hey, how's it going? This is Topher here for biocharisma.com. Right now we're setting up our biochar rocket stove. So basically what I'm attempting to do right now is I put a little seal here. I use the clay and sand, a very light cob mixture, to be the seal on the bottom of the unit. So when we actually place this canister full of biomass, we place it right on top like that and then press down. That acts as a seal, so when we light our fire right here, we get the normal rocket stove reaction where the fire goes through the thermal battery, up the thermal riser, ends up heating all the biomass that's in here, and then we dump all the syngas or the biogas back down into the fire unit for an extra hot burn. This is coconut shell. So anybody that's been following me knows that I'm a huge fan of coconut. One of the reasons why is that the coconut shell itself is an absolute miracle. It's very, very, very densely populated or full of oil. So in doing my biochar, this makes my best biochar out of any of the different biomasses that I've used. This is by far has the highest oil content, therefore the highest heat. So when we fire up our rocket biochar down here, I get the results that I get from this are magnificent. Once again, this is the shell of the coconut. Now that we've filled our retort, basically I want to explain what biochar is. Biochar is non-activated charcoal. The way we get this is that we actually put the coconut shell or whatever our biomass is into a container that when that container is heated, no oxygen can actually get to the material. And this is what crystallizes the carbon and it releases all the volatile gases. We go ahead and cap the system, and what I'll do is I'll just turn down these tabs, and then we'll go ahead and flip this onto our thermal battery over there. So now that we've gone ahead and put on the thermal riser, this particular thermal riser, because it's also making biochar, it's stacking two functions. Number one, it acts as the mode by which we get convection. And secondly, it actually produces our biochar by the heat that is actually being captured by this. Inside of this, the insulation that we're using is biomass. That biomass will go ahead and dump its gas back into the fire chamber, making the fire much hotter. And all I'm doing right now before we light it is I'm taking my cob mixture and I'm sealing any holes. And like I said earlier, I like using the simple seals because, you know, clay is cheap. And this way I can take the unit apart if I need to. So we're on to ignition here. I'm just taking a paper ball. We filled the fire tube full of newspaper, crumpled newspaper. I like to light it from this side because it creates the draft immediately. And so this way it builds a back pressure. As this side heats up, the fire will burn in this direction. And so by the time the fire gets here, the entire tube has been preheated. And that creates an instant draw, a very dramatic draw. The higher our draw, the hotter our heat. And that's what we're looking for. We're looking for a good hot fire because the hotter the fire is, the cleaner the fire is. Okay. We have our rocket stove all primed and pumped. You always want to use split wood this way, and you want to basically just put it in the firebox in a fashion where all the air can flow over this. You should see it, like right now there's an extremely hot fire burning right here, but I can stick my hand in the firebox, and because the air is flowing over my hand, I won't get burnt. This makes it very safe for children. But all the fire is burning in this direction. I don't know if you can see, but we have a flame that's coming up on this side. That flame is being generated from this way. And what we'll see a little bit later is that once this gets up to heat, we'll have a blue flame that's shooting up because of all the syngas that's dumping the extra volatiles into the thermal riser.
That's what I'm talking about.
So this is what we call our real rocket stove. Right now, we're siphoning the syngas from our thermal riser. All the biomass is releasing its gas into the fire chamber. And this is what's giving us our extra burn right here. So this is only about 20 minutes into our fire cycle, and you can see how much wood is actually in our firebox. Very little relative to the amount of BTUs we're producing.
So the question is, how does this little amount of wood, that fire right there, create that amount of flame? And the answer is, all the syngas, all the biogas that's inside this retort is being emptied into the chamber, and it's lighting as it comes up. All right, so we're done with our burn. So there's a couple things that I do here. Number one, I build these units, especially these more rustic units, so I could take the whole thing apart to clean it. So I'll take these bricks off, like this. So it's so simple, the masonry here is nothing too advanced. I usually use this type of ash in my composting toilet. And then this is where the biochar magic is. We just go ahead and flip this unit right off. We flip it upside down, then I just open these tabs here, and then inside's the biochar. So now we're just opening up the thermal riser to see what happened to our biomass. The coconut shells themselves had a ton of oil in them, so it produced this black material right here. This is partly biochar, and it's partly creosote. So creosote is usually used here in the tropics. A lot of people use it to actually seal the posts that they put in the ground. If you wanted to collect this efficiently, you could put like a little radiator on these things where the material will cool and dump into a little oil sump. So here's what our biochar ends up looking like. It sounds like little shards of glass. And if you've ever played with coconut shells, you know how hard they are. Look how this just crushes in my hand. I'm using next to no force. This is the perfect home for probiotic biota, or I should say just healthy microorganisms in your soil. We're gonna go ahead and put effective microorganisms on this right now, a solution, and then we're gonna mix this with our worm castings, and this will give us beautiful soil and basically complete the cycle.